Okay. Can you hear us?
I can hear you. Can you hear me?
We can hear you, and it looks great. So hang on. Let me get you over there where everybody can see you.
Okay.
Okay. Everybody's waving, but you can't see us.
Hey, everybody.
Okay, great. Well, you're good to go whenever you're ready to start.
So you can hear me? Everybody can hear me?
Yep, we can hear you perfect.
All right. Hey, everybody. I can hear them. All right. Welcome to the Philippines. It sounds like we've got a really good crowd there. So we are going to jump right to what we had planned to do. And some of the students at the Cebu Bible College are going to sing a couple of songs for you. And then we're going to let some of them share. So there is an a cappella group here that's doing good things in ministry here in the Philippines. Represent the Cebu Bible College called Straight A. And they're going to sing two songs for you. So you'll enjoy this. Guys, Don, you ready? Go ahead, guys. Are we still good?
Yep, we're great.
All right.
Say that. encouraging school. And one of the things we do to encourage the ministers and help support them is a ministers conference every year. And that's the event that you're sharing in this morning. Thanks for letting John come and share with the ministers and the students in the ministers conference. And also, Austin, his brother, is with us. They have done an exceptional job helping us as we have been walking with Jesus through the Holy Land. John's had the opportunity to share some of his experiences while going to the Holy Land and amplifying some of the messages because of those experiences. Thank you for your concern for what's going on over here and your help and support in that. These guys are very appreciative of that. The whole team is very appreciative of the support we have in front of you guys. Another school that is with us is the Life Change Campus of Lake Day Christian College, Johnny Eastep, and some of his. That's another training school, college, Christian college here in the Philippines. They're located about 3 hours to the south of us. And we do try to do a lot of collaborative kinds of things together, and we appreciate their attendance and their support as well. So thanks again. Enjoy the time. I think John's going to interview some folks, so I'll turn it back over to him.
Good work, Don. Would you come up for just a minute?
He's got, these two didn't know I was going to talk to him. This is Joe Burt and Don. I'm going to have to get closer to him. Is our audio connection still good?
Yep, it's perfect.
All right. Now I come over here. Go work, come on, let's act like we love each other. So these are two staff members. Can you see all three of us?
Yep.
And these are two staff members here at CBC. I met Joe Burt, well, I met Don too, about 10 years ago.
Yes.
When he's still single. He's not single anymore. Joe Burt was actually, well, Don too was living with Mark in his home about 10 years ago on the very first trip I made, right before Casey and I got married. Is Casey there?
Yep, she is.
Hey, Casey. That's not why, fellas. So I wanted to introduce them to you, and I wanted to give them a chance to talk. I've got just a couple of questions I'm going to ask these students. I'm going to invite one of our students up, and then I want you to experience what we've been experiencing every trip that we've ever made, but also this week we're going to congregationally sing, just so that you're sure it's not the worship and the passion and praise isn't just reserved for a select few, but it fills this place, and it's really incredible. So, Don, why don't you tell the crowd why you are here, why you've chosen to teach at CBC?
I've been coming and going. You know, I've been going to Singapore a couple of times, and I was there for 5 years. And I was doing a worship ministry, but I always got back to CBC because I believe in what CBC is doing, and I'm thankful and grateful for the privilege, the opportunity to mentor gifted and young students who are thirsty and hungry for learning. Yeah, that for me really could not find in so many places. People who are willing to be trained, I mean, they think that I'm actually training them and actually learning from them as I teach. And for that, I really am thankful. That's the reason why I will go back to CBC.
Joe Burt, why are you here?
Well, I believe by faith that this is the purpose that God set for my life. So I am more than blessed to be with the students every time we are together teaching them and helping them to fulfill and to respond to the calling that God called them. I cannot imagine myself somewhere else. I can be somewhere else. Work. But then again, I am happy and I'm blessed to be in this place. And I like to grow old in this place, in my family.
I want you to tell the folks back in the U.S. What you've learned this week in this particular conference this week. Second question for Joe.
I have learned that as Christians, we should be disciples. That we should always be learning and yearning to grow into the likeness of Christ every day. And it should be our goal in prayer to be shaped, you know, our hearts and our lives, to be shaped according to the likeness of Christ. You know, I'm a worship leader and I'm passionate about worship. But if we excel in worship and we fail in discipleship, then we're not really fulfilling, you know, what God has planned for us as people. And it has to be both. Worship as a lifestyle and discipleship as our goal. Finding people to form them into the likeness of Christ.
I have learned a lot of things this week. I'm actually overwhelmed with the things that I hear this week. And I've never been so attentive. I've never been so attentive ever since.
That's right.
Yeah. Then this week, I'd like to, you know, understand everything that the speakers are saying. And one of the best things that I've heard, it was Monday afternoon, it's about being a disciple. You know, it's easy to be Christians, but we are called to be disciples. And we are called not just to be transformed, but we're supposed to be transformers, which means we go and make disciples. The reality is, some of the churches, or many of the churches here in Cebu are, you know, stagnant when it comes to growing. But this is the missing point. This is the missing word. We need to go and make disciples. And that's one thing that I have learned and so heavy in my heart. We can move from being a Christian to being a disciple.
Amen. To my Netherland Church family, give these guys a round of applause. Come on, Jasper. This is Jasper. Jasper is one of our students at CBC. Can you see Jasper?
Yes.
Jasper, why don't you tell our brothers and sisters in the U.S. About yourself and why you're here at CBC?
Just a kind of young person who likes to serve God. A person who wanted to be used by God. I could have been somewhere else. Because before I entered any Bible school, I have so many plans in my life that I'm not in the practice God prepared for me. So why I came to Bible school. First I went to David Christian College. I was so blessed that God put me in a Bible school because that's how God really forged my convictions on me. And so my motivation for coming here in Bible school is someday I could reach out my own family where not Christians, also to my son.
First, I just wanted to build my foundation for myself. But circumstances happen, and especially I'm with Ryan. God used those circumstances to make me have that foundation. I should really pursue full-time ministry. There's so much work that God wants to accomplish. You know, when I get here to CBC, that's just building my foundation. I think that God will help me to
what I want to do. What specific ministry are you going to be involved in, you hope, when you graduate? Where and what do you want to be doing?
My experiences at CBC, I've been to different ministries. First year, for many years, I've experienced children. My senior year, I've been so perhaps what's in my heart would be spring baby. Relate more to my generation. It's also my goal, especially my friends.
Amen. I want you to tell the crowd back in the U.S. what you've learned this week. What's stood out to you this week? What's helped you in your faith?
This is an overwhelming experience for me this week. And I think the most very thing that touched my heart this week. It's the thought that our life here on earth is about preparation. We've done so much things to ensure our salvation is right, but actually God wants us to have this kind of life. You know, the best things are to happen here. I was taught so much about the prayer. I cannot explain so much, but I just wrote it in the song. God wanted us to have this.
One of the amazing things that I have learned is that, you know, back home, we have talked a lot about going, making, being. We talked about a certain amount. We've talked about prayer, as Mark has shared and I have shared those lessons. And we got to share some of those same truths here in the context of the Philippines and to see what God is doing in our home, but then to see also what God, through the Holy Spirit, is bringing into the world here in the Philippines has been an incredibly experience. And just like we encouraged you months ago to think about the Lord's Prayer and to write a version of the Lord's Prayer for yourself, we encouraged these students to do as well. And Jasper wrote his own version of the Lord's Prayer in song. And he shared that with the big group last night. I'm going to share that with you when we get home because I recorded it and it was it was given to him by the Lord. And we're so grateful that Jasper shared that. So can my family and Netherland give Jasper a round of applause? So one of the things, as I said earlier, that has always been overwhelming to me about time in the Philippines is to experience how passionate they are about ministry, how passionate the churches are here about worship. And so I want to share that experience with you. And so as a group, we're going to sing. And I'm going to turn the volume down on my machine so that if you would like to join in as they sing, because it's a song that we know. So that we don't get feedback going, across the Pacific Ocean. I would encourage you to worship along with us as we worship. Give us just a minute to get ready. We're going to sing a song. 350 in the book of the Philippines. What's the Jesus, hold my hand. I don't know what number it is in the Songs of Faith and Praise that we've got at home, but Jesus, hold my hand is the song that we're going to sing. So give us just a minute to get ready, and then after we sing this song, we'll sing the whole thing. Let's sing the whole song, and then we'll make a couple of remarks, and then we'll let you guys finish up service back home. So give us just a minute to get ready. Would you all be willing to sing with us here?
Yes, absolutely.
All right, very good.
I'm going to leave the mic up so that you can hear it, but I'm going to turn the audio down.
As I travel to this pilgrim land, there is a man who wants me to be. This is every to the sinking sand, it is the price of Calvary. This would be my prayer, Lord, it is lifted up into the best I can. For I need my life to guide me day and night, blessed Jesus, hold my hand. Blessed Jesus, hold my hand, I beside you, yeah. Oh, Lord, dear Lord, I'm not
Are we still there?
Yes.
All right. I don't want to put straight A out, but would you sing Waka Waka? We're going to sing one more song. Is that okay?
Absolutely.
I know that the time was short, but my hope and prayer is that you would see that God is very big and that God is doing things in our community, but also here in the Philippines and across the world, that we would be praying about and thinking about how we can help, how we can support, how we can pray for, how we can give of our resources for this work, but also works across the world. So I'm grateful to our leadership for allowing me to come. I'm thankful for what they're doing. And I've had a great experience. And I'm looking forward to being home with you on Sunday. It's going to be a long couple of days as we journey home, but we're looking forward to be there. But be praying for the work here at CBC. Be praying for the students here as they glorify God. And we appreciate you letting us take over the service on Wednesday night.
I can say on behalf of all of us, it was a true blessing. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Thank you. God bless you guys. We'll see you on Sunday. Bye, Casey.